Ladies and gentlemen, this is Eddie Marcus again. This message is specifically for the white man. Only for the white man. If you're not white, if you're black, Chinese, any other color, this is not for you. And though you happen to end up with it, turn it off and go someplace else. Nothing but for the white man. Mr. White Man, I need to talk to you for a minute. Do you recognize how you are seen worldwide? I want to know, what is it that allows you to do the things you do? Have you thought about it? I haven't given it much thought. Years ago, there was a gentleman by the name of Elijah Muhammad. He said that you were the devil. He said that you came straight out of the pit of hell. And he didn't say that by the way you looked. He said that because of the way you acted. And it just so happened that you were white. And some of his students, like Malcolm X and so many others, agreed with him that you were the devil. Now, I know you don't think you're a devil, and you get insulted every time you might hear somebody say that. And I'm not saying you're the devil. No, not by a long shot. But I think about all of the evil that goes on in the world. It seems that it's carried on by white people. When I think about this country alone, I think about how you took the natives and all of the things that you did to the natives to make them become white. Even did experiments to see if you can turn them into being white people. Even though their skins might be a little color, different color, turn them into white people. And I'm sure that you did the same things for blacks as well. But you had perhaps a little bit different flavor with the blacks because you had done them so dirty as slaves. But I think about it. I think about all over the Middle East, wherever you go, you take violence with you as if you want to control everything. I think about here in the United States of America, how you just don't care about anything. And I kind of understand that, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, white gentlemen. I grew up in the South. And I was educated in the schools that you allowed us to have. I was educated on television. The stuff that you gave us. The propaganda that we had in movies and documentaries. And what you were afraid of, I was afraid of. You were afraid of natives. At least that's the way you depicted them. And I was afraid of natives. You were afraid of Africans. By the way you depicted them, I was afraid of Africans. It was that you trained us to be exactly what you wanted us to be until we learned the truth, and then we began to make a change back to what we want to be. This is sickening. Think about it. There are many, many good, wonderful, God-fearing white people. But you've heard the expression, the only thing worse than a low-down, dirty person is a good person that knows of the actions of the low-down, dirty people and do nothing. I heard that one time when blacks were under your foot, that there were Quaker people. They weren't black. They had a religion that allowed them to be above what carnal white people were like. And they extended a hand of support to slaves. And even in the black struggle since that time up through this day, there are many white people who will lend out their hands, who do not want to be associated with the evil of the power structure of you. Today we have recognized, and white people are telling us amongst themselves and through the internet and Facebook and books, they are telling us that the powers that be have united themselves at the top. It didn't just happen. It is represented that the people from the Garden of Eden have had one thing in mind, and that was to control and take over and be God on earth. Someone might think that if God made a white man and made a yellow man and made a red man, made a black man, that God might have wanted his bouquet of flowers to be beautiful in his sight. But you you as God. Want one kind of people, and that's you. And if anybody else want to exist, they got a black man got to be a better white man than you. An Indian has to be a better white man than you. A Chinese got to be a better white man than you, where you can go and sleep and wall and ponds and play and have a good time, because you don't have anything to worry about, because your white people in all these different shades have been trained and they are afraid of you. But I want to tell you something. You are not God. And like I would say to my black brethren, we have to rise up and allow the Spirit of God to be utilized and expressed in us to the extent that we have no fear of what you can do to us. In fact, we invite your evilness to come out and do exactly what it has been done. But we're not just stopping there. We're asking white men of good taste, of good fabric, to cut this junk out. Why is it that the secret societies, all of them controlled by white people, who plan to wipe out billions of us, billions of human beings, including whites, just so you can play God? And white people, they are going to do it to you too. They're going to do it to everybody that they don't need. Turn us all into slaves. But I can tell you this, your freedom lies in your faith and your belief in God, not in just going to church, sitting up in booths. You realize that all the evil that white people have done throughout existence, churches have been sitting up there preaching, using the Bible to support whatever white men do. You have mega churches. There are not too many black mega churches. I'm sure they do the same thing that white mega churches do. But the white mega churches, you're telling people to maintain this stuff. You're not telling them any kind of truth. Well, I just wanted to say a little bit to you. I'm not going to try to change you, like I'm not trying to change black people. I just mentioned a note to black people, and I wanted to be fair and mention a note to you as well. You are not God. And I can tell you, you're going to lose. Even if you destroyed all the people on earth that you plan to, and got in that position just as you want, the same people that's remaining can wipe you out. All they need is God. So people, white people, listen to me. You're not good. You're not good. And you will lose if you go against God. Bye-bye.